Hi everyone, myself Dr. Manjunath Asi, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. In this video, I would like to explain about the conducting polymer, that is polyaniline, its synthesis and how it conducts electricity and its application in biomedical field and as well as engineering. What is polyaniline? Polyaniline is a polymer of aniline. It is also called PANI, that has been extensively used as a conducting polymer. So because of its variable band gap, in its reduced state, its band gap is reported as 4.3 electron volt, and in the oxidized form, its band gap is reported as 2.7 electron volt. So because of this tunable band gap, this polyaniline is used in various applications, including drug delivery, photovoltaic cells, plastic batteries, display devices, microelectronics, electrodes, and chemical sensors, biosensor, corrosion protection, LEDs, polymer light emitting diodes, displays, etc. So let us look at how this polyaniline is synthesized in the laboratory. So for the synthesis of polyaniline, you have to take two beakers, about 250 ml, two beakers. In both of them, we have to take 50 ml of 1 molar HCl. Take 50 ml of 1 molar HCl in this, and also 50 ml of 1 molar HCl in this. Now, you add 5 grams of ammonium persulfate. This ammonium persulfate is an oxidizing agent in this beaker. So ammonium persulfate is dissolved in HCl in this beaker. Next, in another beaker, 2 ml of aniline is added in this beaker containing 50 ml of HCl. Then, after dissolving these two, then you transfer this ammonium persulfate solution into this aniline solution slowly by maintaining the temperature almost equal to zero or less than 0 degrees centigrade with constant stirring. You have to add drop by drop of ammonium persulfate into this aniline with constant stirring, maintaining the temperature of 0 degrees centigrade, because the reaction is highly exothermic in nature. So if you do not maintain high temperature, it may lead to the decomposition of the polymer, that polyaniline formed. So therefore, maintaining 0 degrees centigrade and stirring is very, very important. So after stirring for some time, then the reaction gets completed. Then you will end up with a green color powder with other HCl and solution, etc. Then that product has to be extracted by filtering. Then it has to be washed with HCl. If any unreacted aniline is present, that should be removed by reacting with HCl, followed by distilled water. And you need to wash several times with the distilled water. Finally, you have to wash the residue with acetone and dried at 60 degrees centigrade. So this is a simple procedure used for the preparation of polyaniline. Next, let us look at the reaction involved during the synthesis of polyaniline. Here, aniline is actually Lewis base. Okay, so when you add HCl, when you add 2 ml of aniline into HCl, it undergo neutralization reaction. This is a Lewis base and this is a Bronsted acid. So this will this lone pair of electrons combines with H plus. HCl splits into H plus and Cl minus. This H plus forms a bond with lone pair of electrons of nitrogen atom of amine group in aniline and forms anilinium ion. That anilinium ion combines with this Cl minus chloride ion and it forms a salt, anilinium chloride salt. This is basically acid plus base is equal to salt, neutralization reaction. A pure product is formed. So then that formed anilinium chloride is subjected to oxidative polymerization by using ammonium persulfate. Ammonium persulfate acts as an initiator. It initiates the reaction of oxidative polymerization at 0 degrees centigrade and you end up in the polyaniline, the green color product. That product will have two types of benzene rings, two types of backbones. Some X percent of that polymer has quininide structure. You can see that this is a quininide backbone in which nitrogen is completely oxidized, no hydrogen atom. Here, there is some percentage of benzenoid backbone present in the polyaniline. In benzenoid backbone, nitrogen is reduced form, means it is in NH form. It is in N form. So, aniline with this structure can be converted to conducting polyaniline that I'll discuss in the next slide. Okay. So, during the synthesis, aniline can form, aniline can exist in four forms. The first one is leucoemeraldine, second one emeraldine base, or it can exist in emeraldine salt, or it can exist in pernicranoline. Pernicranoline, that depends on the percentage of X. What is that X? X is the composition of quininide and benzenoid. If X is zero, then you will have only benzenoid backbone. If X is equal to zero, you will have only benzenoid backbone. That is called leucoemeraldine. That aniline has only benzenoid structure in which nitrogen atoms are completely reduced. In that form, that polyaniline is not conducting and it is colorless and it is an insulator in nature. Suppose if X is 1, if X is equal to 1, then benzenoid will not be there. Benzenoid backbone will not be there. That formed aniline will have completely made up of quininoid benzene rings. If X is equal to 1, then polyaniline will have only benzenoid. See the benzenoid structure, alternative benzenoid structure with nitrogen atoms are completely oxidized and it is neutral substance and its color is purple. Means that is also insulated. This form is called pernicranoline. If you get colorless product, means you are getting leucoemeraldine. Means that it has only benzenoid structure. If you are getting purple colored product, please remember that you are getting only quininoid structure and that is also insulator and that is its name is pernicranoline. You should not get neither leucoemeraldine nor pernicranoline because both of them are insulator. One is completely reduced benzenoid backbone, other one is completely oxidized quininoid backbone. But for conducting, we should have both the backbones, benzenoid and as well as quininoid. So we can expect if X is 0.5, then you will get a emeraldine base. In that form, that aniline can exist, that polyaniline can exist, contain both the structures. One is a benzenoid structure and other one is a quininoid structure. Okay. So this color will be blue. So if you are getting blue, means you are getting emeraldine base. The base is because this nitrogen is having a lone pair of electrons. This quininide nitrogen, that is oxidized nitrogen, will have a lone pair of electrons. They can react with H+. Therefore, it is Lewis basic. We can call this as a Lewis base. Okay. This is also insulated. All the three forms, leucoemeraldine, emeraldine base, and pernicranoline, all are insulators in nature. When you add some amount of acid to this emeraldine base, when you add acid to base, what do you get? We get a salt that is called emeraldine salt. Emeraldine salt is obtained by adding HCl, this H plus and X minus, to the emeraldine base. The H plus combines with a lone pair of electrons and it forms a ammonium cation, we can say that. And it is a charge carrier. So this is like this, you are creating the charge in the backbone. So because of the conjugation, aromatic conjugation, the charge propagates from one end to other end. That leads to the flow of electrons from one side to other side. And hence, this polyaniline conducts electricity. So therefore, emeraldine salt is a conducting form of polyaniline and its color changes to green color. To the blue color emeraldine base, if you add required quantity of acid, it turns to green color and it becomes conducting. So these are the four different forms of polyaniline. Among them, one is completely reduced, partially oxidized, not neutralized. This is partially oxidized, neutralized. Another one is completely oxidized. This has only a nitrogen group. This has only an NH group. This has both N and NH group, but it is not neutralized and it is basic in nature. This is this has both nitrogen and as well as NH group, and it is neutralized with some amount of acid. It is green color. So if you are getting green color product, this color product, that is, that means this is emeraldine salt is formed, that is conducting polyaniline. Next, let us look at the polymerization mechanism involved in the formation of that polyaniline. So it involves three steps. It is a free radical polymerization, and it is catalyzed by ammonium persulfate is the initiator. We take aniline is the reactant. In the initiation, the first step, aniline reacts with the initiator. Initiator oxidizes that aniline and creates that free radical. That is, anilinium free radical is formed. So that anilinium free radical in the next step, in the propagation step, this anilinium free radical in acidic medium, it undergo substitution or reaction at para position of fresh aniline. This is the fresh aniline. At para position, it forms a bond like this. And we'll get another neutral dimer of dimer, and that again reacts with initiator APS and it forms. It lead to the formation of another free radical. So that free radical again, it undergo, it reacts at the para position of fresh aniline. So like that, the polymerization, that initiation and propagation keeps on happening, leading to the formation of this polyaniline. So finally, you will get a green color polyaniline in acidic medium that is called emeraldine salt. So this has both benzenoid structure and quininoid structure and neutralized form. So this mechanism actually reported by this research group published in last year in American Chemical Society of publication in this Journal of Medicinal Chemistry Journal. So I thank this the group members for this wonderful mechanism, the proposed. Next, the very importantly, the application part of polyaniline. So polyanilines are widely used in solar cells, energy harvesting, and especially in chemical sensor, biosensors, electrochemical sensor applications, and defense applications where they use sensors in which they use, in which the polyaniline is used as one of the conducting material. So this is one of the image that I took from this journal. Sung-Hun Chow et al. Published in Polymers in the last year, and they reported that the polyaniline embedded with poly 4 styrene sulfonate, PANI CSSA. They worked on these two material, PANI CSA and PANI PSS. PSS is actually camphor sulfonic acid, polyaniline camphor sulfonic acid. And these two materials, they used in all these applications. They found its application in solar cell in which light is converted to electricity. And also it is being used in thermoelectric where the heat energy is converted to electricity. And it is being used in supercapacitor where electrical energy is stored. And also in the telecommunication devices in antenna and electrochromic devices. I'll show you in detail about that in the next slide. And in PDMS coatings and OFET substrates and all, they use for electronic devices and EMI shielding, chemical sensor, biosensors. You can find large number of applications starting from electronics, electrical, mechanical, aerospace, defense, and also in medicine applications in biotechnology. Almost in all the fields, you can find the polyaniline applications. This is actually electrochromic device. This is the glass door in the offices being coated with this polyaniline, functionalized polyaniline. You can see that in the switch off mode, it is transparent. You can see the clouds and all outside. When the power is applied, when the electricity is supplied, it becomes opaque. Such type of materials can be developed by using this polyaniline. and it's used in flexible LEDs and transparent displays, etc. So this is a transparent display used developed by Samsung using this polyaniline and conducting polymers. So with this, I'm completing my discussion about the polyaniline and its synthesis procedure and the reaction involved during its synthesis and the mechanism involved in the conduction and different forms of polyaniline and also its application in various fields. If you find any doubts or if you want to ask any questions or clarifications, please email me through this email ID. Thank you for watching.